In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And welcome to our Mass. Welcome to our third Sunday of Easter. It's so a blessing that we can be here this weekend, and of course not as we start Monday, but knowing that whether we're home, whether we're here, knowing that we're praying for one another, that we're asking for God's graces in this Easter season for our families and for our neighbors and for our community. So, and thanksgiving and very much goodness, we ask our God, the risen Lord Jesus, to watch over us in these trying times, to help us and guide us and protect us and to protect our neighbors. So we just take a moment in silence as we start this Mass. We open ourselves to God's graces and God's always offering of forgiveness.
You ascend to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father, where you intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. All glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good news. We bless you, we praise you, we adore you, we glorify you, give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. May your people exalt forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in restored glory of our adoption, may we look forward to confident hope, to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. At the temple gate, Peter addressed the people. The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. The God of our fathers has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and rejected in the presence of Pilate, though he had decided to release him. But you rejected the Holy and Righteous One, and asked to have a murderer given to you. And you killed the author of life, whom God raised from the dead. To this we are witnesses. And now, brothers and sisters, I know that you acted in ignorance, as did also your rulers. In this way, God fulfilled what he had foretold through all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and turn to God, so that your sins may be wiped out. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Justice.
St. John. My little children, I am writing these things to you so that you may not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the atoning sacrifice for our sins. And not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. Now by this, we may be sure that we know him, if we obey his commandments. Whoever says, I have come to know him, but does not obey his commandments, is a liar. And in such a person, the truth does not exist. But whoever obeys his word, truly in this person, the love of God has reached perfection. By this, we may be sure that we are in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Said to them, peace be with you. They were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, why are you frightened and why do your doubts rise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet and see that it is I myself. Touch me and see, for a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you see that I have. And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy, they were disbelieving and still wondering. He said to them, have you anything here to eat? They gave him a piece of broiled fish and took it and ate it in their presence. Then he said to them, these are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets and the Psalms must be fulfilled. Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, thus it is written that the Christ is to suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This is the third Sunday of Easter. The daily readings through the week show how the attitude of the disciples changed from being learners to being evangelists, from being terrified to being self-assured and confident. And 2 weeks ago in the Passion reading, we heard how Peter denied Jesus. And in today's reading, he is leading the charge for righteousness. He uses the scriptures to prove that Jesus is the Messiah, the true Son of God. He sternly accuses the people that because of their ignorance of the truth, they were responsible for the death of Jesus. They chose a murderer, Barabbas, instead of Jesus, to be set free. But Peter does this with love and not with condemnation and judgment. He implores the people to repent and to turn back to God the Father. Peter realizes that all the prophecies spoken about Jesus having to suffer and die were true, and although it stressed him out, he let it unfold and he surrendered to the will of Jesus. That's why Jesus said to Peter before, "Get behind me, Satan," when Peter tried to stop him from going to Jerusalem where he would die. My brothers and sisters, and that's why Peter didn't condemn or seek justice from the people for the crucifixion of Jesus, because it would serve no purpose. The foundation of Jesus' teaching was love, is love and forgiveness, and was revealed in the truth about him. Anyone who wishes to follow Jesus must have the same love and mercy in himself. Our own response to being ill-treated by others must always be one of forgiveness and love. And this, of course, brings to mind the words, "If your enemy slaps you on the cheek, turn the other cheek to him also." And remember the words of Jesus, "Forgive them, Father, for they don't know what they do." All three readings this Sunday speak about the ongoing mission of the apostles and points the way that the church must follow. The mission of the church is to reveal the truth about Jesus and to bring people to repentance. The sacrament of reconciliation and or confession, as we know it, is a direct response to Peter's plea to the people to repent of their sins and return to God to have all their sins forgiven. Now, in the second reading, we hear John instruct the people on how they can reconcile with God. And two things are necessary. Accept Jesus as the only Son of the Father and repent of your sins. In this way, a person is forgiven their sins and begin to live the new life. And what is this new life? Remember when the Pharisees arrested Peter and the apostles and they threw them into prison? And during the night, an angel appeared to them. He opened the gates of the prison and he set them free. But most importantly, he told them, "Go and stand in the temple and tell the people the whole message about this life." The life the angel speaks of is the same life that I'm referring to. It works in this way. We prove our love for God by having the desire to sin no more, and by repentance of past and future sins. There is no need for God to prove his love for us, because it has its own proof in the scriptures. As we hear in the Gospel of John, all things came through him, and without him nothing came to be. And what came to be through him was life, and this life was the light of the human race. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome. What does this mean? It means the life we live now must be lived through the light, who is Jesus. And by living through Jesus, we can safely remain in the light, because Jesus has overcome the darkness. And if we live in the law of God, the light is in us, and the light will destroy the darkness, and it will never consume us. The law of God is his love for us. As Jesus says, it is not burdensome, but only leads to peace and joy. And it works like this. If we sin, we feed the darkness, and the darkness will overcome us. That's why John says, "Whoever says, 'I know Jesus,' but does not obey his commandments is a liar. And in such a person, the truth does not exist." Dr. Scott Horn reminds us, it is good to read and listen to the scriptures, but not just to understand more about Jesus in the historical sense, but to know him personally, to develop a healthy relationship, and to discover his plans for our lives through faithfulness. In this way, we can share our faith with others, not only with the facts about Jesus, but by day-to-day love affair that we experience living in the light with him. Many people say, "I am waiting for the second coming and Jesus will come and take us home." I would say, no need to wait. He never left us. Jesus has been here for the past 2,000 years. We will not be able to see him physically or to shake his hand, but Jesus told us he would never leave us. He is the light that shines in you. Every time you say a kind word and give a thirsty person a drink of water, or when you visit your aged parents, or visit someone in hospital or prison, you see Jesus every week when you visit the church for Mass. He is right here in this tabernacle. You know he is there. Because when the red candle is burning, it means there is Eucharist in there. And that Eucharist is Jesus. The person waiting for the second coming really meant to say, I am waiting for the time when I see Jesus riding through the clouds on a white horse with the words King of Kings and Lord of Lords written on his thigh. Then the time for judgment and condemnation has come. But it won't come from us. It will come from Jesus himself. God bless you.
We now together profess our faith, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. On this third Sunday of Easter, we bring to God our Easter prayers from ourselves, from our families, from our friends, and from our community that God will hear us. For the church, during this Easter season, calling us to see Jesus in our brothers and sisters, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for world leaders working together to find solutions to our global problems, especially for the strife in Myanmar at this time, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who call out in their need, and for those who respond, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the members of this parish community, working to be faithful followers of Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those in need of healing, strength, in mind, body, and spirit, all those that are sick, all frontline workers, all those working in COVID-19 situations, and all their caregivers, for this we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
and for those who have died marked with a sign of faith, and all those who grieve their loss, especially for the Mass offerings for this evening, and for all those who have died, for them we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
and for all the needs that we care in the quiet of our hearts, this day we pause. For these we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
God of Easter, we thank you for hearing our prayers from our people and from our brothers and sisters. We bring our prayers to Jesus, our risen Lord, for he lives forever and ever. Amen. Amen. My sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to claim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously. When Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed, he never ceased to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is a sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal Easter joy, every land, every people exult in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the hymn of your glory, as we now acclaim together as we say: Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered unwillingly into his own passion, Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, he broke the bread, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Douglas our Bishop, the clergy, and all the people of God. Remember also our brothers and our sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and Saints, Saint Teresa, Saint Kateri, who please you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and form of divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy may we always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grace ye grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other now a sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter into your house,
the body of Christ. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you have pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Just a few announcements this weekend. As you heard yesterday, that starting Monday, that we won't be having in-service Mass for at least, I guess, 5 to 6 weeks. And then when we hear more at that time, we will do different ways of communicating to you about that from us here at the office and for myself. We'll be, as we've been doing over 13 months now, with Jeff's good hard work, you never get the day off, and the music people as well too, they always assist as well too. So we'll be taping Masses for the next 6 weeks, so on our website, also on YouTube, St. Teresa Elmira, that'll be up at some point Sunday morning, depending on, again, Jeff's schedule. He's always very busy with many other things, so that'll be up Sunday morning. A couple of the things that we do have on our rosary on Wednesday evenings, and then I think the movie night will also be following the same night. Yeah, so we're gonna have, it's called The Chosen, and we'll offer different movies and good Catholic movies after that. That will be, just check the website for that. I think, how do they get in again, Deacon Basil?
My email's in the bulletin, it should be on.
Yeah, so if you...
email me and I'll send a link out.
Yeah, so if you want a very good Catholic movie, so that'd be Wednesday evening, you can come after the rosary as well too. So that will be happening. Also, the weekly reflections will also be Wednesday afternoon. This coming week will be on the Pope's intention for this month. And then this past week in Rome, there was actually a conference on Teresa of Avila, because 50 years ago she became the Doctor of the Church, first female. We'll be talking about that, one of our reflections. So again, reflections on Wednesday, Mass on Sunday, and so many things we'll do. If you have any questions about the bulletin, any questions you may have, we'll be checking the phones again every day. Every couple of hours we do check the phones. So we have the rosary in that movie. What else do we have? Also, we're hoping to do a few more things as well too. We're calling everybody as well too in their homes to make sure that they're okay. So I think that's pretty well it. But again, know that we'll be praying for you, Deacon Basil and myself, daily in our prayers and in our daily prayers of our Liturgy of the Hours, and also at Mass and at the Tate Mass. So again, you are in our prayers. Anything you might need or concern, again, you are important to us. All of you are important to us. We thank you for what you do. Your prayers and your support are ongoing. Thank you so much. You'll hear more about another financial report from last year coming up very soon. We'll be having a pastoral council, all by Zoom, of course. So we thank you again for your generosity, and may God bless you all. And I think I always forget something, but again, we thank all of you for being here and what you do for our parish. Thank you all so very, very much. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.